Good morning, you guys. If you looked in our slides today, you saw that today's National Day is Arbor Day. And Arbor is just kind of another word for trees, and it's a day where we celebrate trees. So I thought I would read one of my favorite books that also happens to be about trees. And I bet you guys have read it before, or maybe even seen it, but it's called The Giving Tree and it's by Shel Silverstein. So I'm going to read this story with you this morning because it is one of my favorites. Oops, we went too far. Once there was a tree. And she loved a little boy. And every day the boy would come. And he would gather her leaves and make them into crowns and play king of the forest. He would climb up her trunk and swing from her branches. Look, you can see his feet are like inside of the tree up there. And eat apples. Look, there's little apple cores falling down. And they would play hide and go seek. And when he was tired, he would sleep in her shade. And the boy loved the tree very much. And the tree was happy. You can even see on this last page, he made a little heart on the tree that says, "Me and T." What do you think T stands for? The tree. Sometimes tree is another word where when we say it fast, it might sound like it starts with a ch-ch-ch-ch, but it actually starts with a TR, tree. And the tree was happy. But time went by. What do you notice about the boy? He's starting to get older. And the boy grew older. And the tree was often alone. And then one day the boy came to the tree and the tree said, "Come, boy, come and climb up my trunk and swing from my branches and eat apples and play in my shade and be happy." "I'm too big to climb and play," said the boy. "I want to buy things and have fun and I want some money. Can you give me some money?" "I'm sorry," said the tree, "but I don't have any money. I have only leaves and apples." "Take my apples, boy, and sell them in the city and then you will have money and then you will be happy." So it's kind of, I don't know about you, but I start to feel kind of sad at this part because he used to be just a little boy who just loved the tree for being able to play in it. And now he's looking at the tree to give him something more to make him happy, like to give him money. And he thinks money is going to be the thing that might make him happy. And he's asking this tree who's given him so much for some money. And she gives it to him. She says, "You can take my apples and sell them if you want some money." And so the boy climbed up the tree and gathered her apples and carried them away. And the tree was happy. So the tree's happy to give up things for the boy because the tree loves the boy. But the boy stayed away for a long time and the tree was sad. And then one day the boy came back and the tree shook with joy. And she said, "Come, boy. Climb up my trunk and swing from my branches and be happy." "I'm too busy to climb trees," said the boy. Look how old he is now. "I want a house to keep me warm," he said. "And I want a wife and I want children and so I need a house. Can you give me a house?" "I have no house," said the tree. "The forest is my house. But you can cut off my branches and build a house. Then you will be happy." Can you believe she's saying that? "You can cut off my branches and build yourself a house?" Even though he's telling her, I'm too busy to climb trees and all I want is a wife and children." And he's asking her for even more. And so the boy cut off her branches and he carried them away to build his house. And you can see what the tree is left with. She doesn't have her branches anymore. But the tree was happy. She's happy to be able to give him things. So amazing. But the boy stayed away for a long time. And when he came back, the tree was so happy she could hardly speak. Come, boy, she whispered. Come and play. I'm too old and sad to play, said the boy. I want a boat that will take me far away from here. Can you give me a boat? Cut down my trunk and make a boat, said the tree. Then you can sail away and be happy. The last thing she has left is her trunk, and she's offering it to him. So the boy cut down her trunk, and he made a boat and sailed away. And the tree was happy, but not really. And after a long time, the boy came back again. I'm sorry, boy, said the tree, but I have nothing left to give you. My teeth are too weak for apples, said the boy. My branches are gone, said the tree. You cannot swing on them. I'm too old to swing on branches, said the boy. My trunk is gone, said the tree. You cannot climb. I'm too tired to climb, said the boy. I'm sorry, said the tree. I wish that I could give you something, but I have nothing left. I'm just an old stump. I'm sorry. I don't need very much now, said the boy. Just a quiet place to sit and rest. I am very tired. Well, said the tree, straightening herself up as much as she could. Well, an old stump is good for sitting and resting. Come, boy, sit down. Sit down and rest. And the boy did. And the tree was happy. The end. Oh, I love that story. I love, love, love how generous the tree is. Zachary used that word yesterday to describe Spencer, but I just love that the tree always wants to give the boy something. And look how little he is on the cover here. And she just gives her whole self for him to make him happy. It's so sweet. I hope you guys have a great day, and thank you for listening to the story.